lengthy so the air won't slow it down. We made a thin body so the rocket would be more aerodynamic and will go faster. And we made 3 fins to keep it stable. The fins are going to be triangular so they are aerodynamic.
Creating our nose cone was easy. We used paper to create it. When choosing on how many fins, we decided on 3.
To build our rocket's body, we used a PVC pipe and wrapped construction paper around it, and then used electrical tape to secure it.
Crafting our rocket was really fun because we got to find out how high our rocket went. Our rocket went 84 feet and the class average was 61, so we were really proud that we beat the class average. As Hannah said, we were really happy that our rocket went higher than the class average.
We tried to copy Rocket 1, so we used same thick body, a pointing nose cone, but we used 3 longer fins. When we were building our body, we used sturdier construction paper so we had more control when it was in the air. We went 50 feet and class average is 96 feet.
Our first rocket went lower than our second rocket. Our second rocket went lower than our first rocket, which was 84 feet. We were pretty disappointed. Our favorite part was designing and building our rocket, even if we weren't happy with the results. For rocket 3, we're using a pointy paper nose cone to keep it simple, and we're using a more thin body because that's what the other successful groups use. And we're using 3 fins to keep it stable. We definitely think we improved much more in the second rocket on our collaboration. Building our rocket was the easiest because we already had a design, so we just followed the plan.
The hardest was always trying to agree on what to do.
We learned in our group that everybody has to work together to accomplish their goals.